In this video session, I am explaining about servlet and JSP chapter from module 4, subject Advanced Java and J2EE. So topics covered in this video session are handling HTTP request and HTTP response, using cookies and session tracking. Next topic is handling HTTP request and HTTP response. The HTTP servlet class provides a specialized method that handles the various type of HTTP request methods. The different methods of HTTP request and HTTP response are doGet, doPost, doOperation, doPut, doTrace and doDelete. Let us see the first method, HTTP doGet method. The doGet method is used inside the servlet that gets called every time a request from either HTML or JSP page is submitted. The control first reaches the doGet method of the servlet, then servlet decides what functionality to invoke based on the submit request by the client. The get method called when the type of page submission is get. The doGet is used when there is a requirement of sending data appended to query string in the URL. The doGet cannot be used to send too much information appended as a query string. Get puts the form value into the URL string. The get is limited to about 256 characters and creates regularly in URLs. So whenever the client will send an input parameter, if I am using a doGet method, then whatever the values are passed, those values are going to be get appended on the URL. The doGet method cannot be used for data security reason, like login page. When I'm going to do creating a login page, if I apply the doGet method, then username and password values are be seen on the URL. In that case, the doGet method cannot be used. Whenever there is a possibility to send a value, in that case the doGet methods have been used. The general syntax of doGet method is public void doGet. It takes the two argument. One argument is request belonging to an interface called as an HTTP servlet request interface. Another argument is response belonging to an interface called HTTP servlet response interface. This method is going to throw an exception called servlet exception and IO exception. In order to handle this exception, we'll use a keyword called throws. This is an general syntax of using doGet method. Thus, doGet methods are being used when there is a type of page submission is get. This is a simple program to display the sum of two numbers on the browser, where the values are passed by the client by making use of an doGet method. Here the two files are be created. One is a web page by making use of an HTML, another is to perform the operation, that is a servlet file. So there are two input types, text, the name is given as t1 and name is given as t2 for to read the value. Assume that I given a value 10 and the value as 20. When the client will submit the button, the value 10 and 20 should be passed from HTML to the servlet. Okay, in order to pass those values, we'll make use of a form tag. The form tag contains an action where the value should be passed. That is, we need to specify the name of the class. Here the name of the class is A. Okay, from HTML file, the values are be passed to the class A. And here the method is not specified. If method is not specified, by default, method in a form tag is get. So if the submission type is get, then in order to handle that request, will make use of a method called doGet method. Then the value 10 and 20 will be seen on the URL. Now the servlet has to receive the value and has to perform the operation as sum. In order to do this, we'll make use of a method called doGet, because the submission type is get. So doGet method takes the two arguments. One is a request argument belonging to the interface called as an HTTP servlet request interface. Another is a response object belonging to the interface called as an HTTP servlet response interface. The request interface, which is used to read the input parameter, response interface, which has been used to give a response back to the user, or we can see the content on the browser. These methods throws an exception called as an servlet exception and IO exception. In order to handle the exception, we'll use a keyword called as an throws. So this IO exception has been used just because of the printWriter method. The printWriter method, which is going to throw an exception, is called IO exception. Now here we are writing the set content type. The set content type is a method which is going to write the content on the browser. What type of the content to be displayed on the browser? Either text or HTML or both. So when the content should be specified on the browser, then set content type is a method belonging to the interface called as a response interface. So with the help of an instance of a servlet response interface, we are calling the set content method. Next, I want to write a content on the browser. To write a content on the browser, we'll make use of a method called getWriter. The getWriter is a method which is going to write contents to the browser. In order to write a content to the browser, then I will make use of a method called getWriter, and this is a method belonging to the interface called as a response, because this method is writing on the browser. So the return value of getWriter method is assigned to the printWriter class. Here out is an object of printWriter class. Now I want to read the value which has been passed by the client. In order to read the value passed by the client, we'll make use of a method called getParameter. So getParameter is a method which is going to read the input parameter passed by the client and takes the one argument, that is a type, name of the input type. The name of the input type is T1. Here the name of the input type is T1. Now whatever the value is assigned in a name, type name T1, that value will be assigned as 10. It has been retrieved out. And the getParameter method belonging to the interface called request interface. Through the instance of a request interface, I am invoking the method getParameter. Here I got 10. The getParameter, as already know, that it is written value will be in the form of string. Now this 10 is in the form of a string, not in number. Plus, I am taking then another input type, that is, to read the another input parameter, we return one more get parameter and specify the name of the input type is T2. So value available in the T2 is 20. So the 20 value has been written out and it is in the form of string. Now I need to perform the operation sum of two numbers. So we need to convert the string to the integer. In order to convert string to the integer, we'll use a class called integer. Integer is a class. The parseInt is a method which is going to convert string to the integer type. So the parseInt method is belonging to the class called integer. Now this 10 is a string has been converted to the integer. Similarly, here also we are converting 20 is in the string form. So we are converting into the integer by making use of a parseInt method. Now the both the values in the form of number. It is going to add the result 10 and 20, and the return value will be stored in the form in the variable called sum. Next, I want to print the result sum on the browser. To print the sum on the browser, we will use a method called println method. So the println is a method belonging to the class called as a printWriter class. With the help of an object of printWriter class, I am invoking the method called println. So I am printing the message as sum of two numbers along with its result as sum, that is 30. This is a simple program which is used to read the input parameter from the client, which is a type submission is a get, and in order to handle that submission type get, we'll make use of a doGet method, and to perform the sum of two numbers and to read the input parameter from the client, we have made use of a get parameter method. Next method is do post method. So HTTP do post method. The do post is a method which is used inside the servlet that gets called every time a request from the HTML or JSP call the servlet using the post method. The do post allows you to have extremely dense form and pass that to the server without limitation in a size. You can send any number of the value to the server. There is a no limit in a do post method. There is a get method has a limit that 256 character can be sent. So do post has no limit on the amount of data we can send because the data does not shown on the URL. We can also send the password by making use of a do post. Okay, when you are making use of a service method as a do post. Now even though if you are applying the do post method to the login page, the username and the password is never going to be get displayed because it is not going to write the content on the URL. Instead of that, it is going to embed the values. But this does not mean that the post is truly secure. Okay. Now compared to the get method, the post method is much secure. But the do post method is not completely secure. The syntax of do post method is public void do post takes the two arguments same. One is a request argument belongs to the HTTP servlet request interface. Another response argument that is belonging to the HTTP servlet response. Similarly, the do post method is also going to throw an exception, servlet exception and IO exception. In order to handle this exception, we'll make use of a keyword called throws keyword. This is an general syntax of do post method. This is an simple program to display average of two numbers on the browser. By making use of a do get method, we did sum of two number. We are making use of a do post method to perform the average of two numbers on the browser. Okay, again there are two files are being needed. One file is an HTML to pass a value from the client, and another is an servlet file which is going to handle the input parameters and perform the operation and give response back to the client. So here we are making use of an about do post method. So same again, we are creating the two input types T1 and T2 to read the value and submit button, and the form tag. So assume I have taken the value as 10 as the client has entered and 20 as the client has entered. Okay, when I submit the button, the control will be moved from HTML file to the my servlet code with the help of a form tag. So the form tag contains an attribute called as an action, where the value should be passed. This value should be passed to the class called servlet, and the submission type is specified as a post. If submission type is specified as a post, then in order to handle those submission type, we'll make use of a service method called as a do post. So do post method has been used if submission type is post, then these values are being sent. Now whatever the values as entered by the client, these values are not going to be displayed on the URL. It has been encoded. That's why the do post does not have an limits in size. Now in order to handle this value, we'll make use of a service method called as a do post method. Again, the do post method takes then two arguments. One is an request argument, another is response argument. So request argument is belonging to the interface called as an HTTP servlet request interface, and the response argument is belonging to the interface called as an HTTP servlet response interface. So the do post method is also going to throw an exception called as a servlet exception, and IO exception will be because of my printwriter class. In order to handle this exception, we'll use a keyword called as a throws. Now here we have made use of a set content type method. The set content type is a method which is going to specify types of the content on the browser. Either you can make use of a text as a content on the browser, or you can make use of an HTML as a content on the browser, or you can make both type in a content as a browser. So if anything you are assigning to the browser, then that method is belonging to the interface called as a response interface. With the object of a response interface, I am invoking the method called set content type. Next, I want to write a contents towards the browser. To write a contents towards the browser, we'll make use of a method called getWriter method. So getWriter is a method which is going to write contents to the browser. If any method is writing a contents to the browser, then that method is belonging to the response interface. So through the instance of a response interface, I am invoking the getWriter method. The return value of getWriter method is assigned to the printWriter class. So printWriter is a class which is available in the package called as an IO package, and the printWriter class is going to throw an exception called as an IO exception. So in order to handle the IO exception, we use the keyword called throws. Now I want to read the value which has been passed by the client. To read the value passed by the client, there is a method called as an getParameter method. So getParameter method, which is going to read the input parameter passed by the client and takes then one argument, that is the name of the input parameter. So the t1 is a name which has been assigned to the input type to the text field, that is t1. Now value available in this t1 has been taken out, that is 10 has been taken out with the help of a getParameter method. So the getParameter method belonging to the interface called as a request interface. Through an instance of a request interface, I am invoking the method getParameter. Now the result is in the form of a string. Similarly, I am taking then another input value which is passed by the client with the help of a getParameter, and the input type name is t2. The value which is available in the t2 is 20. The 20 has been retrieved with the help of a getParameter method. So again, this is in the form of a string. Now I want to convert the value string to an integer. We'll make use of a class called as an integer class, and with the help of a parseInt method. The parseInt is a method which is going to convert string to the integer type, and this is a method belonging to the integer class. Now the 10 has been converted to the integer. Now enter here, I will get as an 10. Similarly, I will convert the value of the parameter t2, the 20, to the integer by making use of parseInt method. Here I will get the value as 20 in the form of integer. Now I will add the value 10 and 20, and this result will be stored in the variable called sum of type int. Now I want to find the average of these two numbers. Okay, and I want to display the value onto the browser. In order to display the value onto the browser, we'll make use of a method called println method. So the println is a method belonging to the end class called as a printWriter class. With the help of an object of printWriter class out, I'm invoking the method println method. So with the help of an object of printWriter class, I'm invoking the method println and displaying the message as average of two numbers. And the value of sum which has been taken out after performing the operation, that is 30 and divided by 2. So I will get a result as 15. This is average of two number is 15 on the browser. This is a simple program by making use of a doPost method. Okay, when there is a service method is a doPost, okay, this method has been invoked if and only if my submission type is post. Assume if the submission type is get, and I will use the service method as a post, then this service method is not going to be get executed. It is says unavailable service. Here we are discussing about difference between doGet and doPost method of servlet. The first one is HTTP request. The doGet method request contains only the request line and HTTP, whereas doPost method request along with the line and header, it is also contains the HTTP body. URL pattern. The query string or a form data is simply appended to the URL as name and values pair. When you submit the value, those values will be you are going to see on the URL by making use of doGet method. DoPost method. The form values, name and value pairs are sent in the body of the request. not in URL itself. That's why we are not going to see the value which have been passed by the client on a URL. Instead of sending those value on the URL, it is going to send within the body of the request. Parameter passing. The form elements are passed to the server by appending at the end of the URL. Here, what are the values have been passed? That is, those values are going to be get appended at the end of the URL. First, the path of the file, and followed by the values what are the client has been sent. The do post method. The form elements are passed in the body of the HTTP request. Here, the values are not going to be sent on the URL. Those values are going to be sent in the body of the HTTP request. Size. The parameter data is limited. The limit depends on the container normally. Here the get method having the limit of 256 characters. That's 256 characters you are going to see on the URL. Whereas in do post method can send huge amount of the data to server. We can send, there is no limit to the n characters in a do post because those values are not going to be sent on an URL. Instead of that, the values are going to be sent within the body of HTTP. That is the reason that there is no limit in the do post method for sending the input parameters. Secure. The get method is not a secure because not safe. Now what reason is, the whatever the values we enter, those values are going to be seen on a browser. Assume that I am making use of a login page, or if I am making use of a transaction page, if I use the service method and submission type is a get, automatically my account number, password and everything is going to be seen on the URL. So that is the reason it says that do get method is not a safe or secure. The do post method is safe. Because here the values are not embedded in the URL, means the user is not going to see what the value has been passed by the client. That is the big reason that the do post method is secure. The data format of do get method support ASCII values, whereas in do post method support ASCII plus binary values. This is a data format the which has been passed from the client to the server. These are the reference which have been referred in the entire slide. The textbook is Albert Stead, Java, the complete reference, 7th edition, Tata McGrail and Jim Cook, and reference book are Daniel Lang, Stephens and Uttam K. Roy. These are the textbook which are going to be referred.